All right, welcome in, folks. Welcome in. I hope everyone's doing well on this lovely Friday. What? Nani Prophet? Nani? Let me turn this music down. Let's put on some happy EDM. Ask your smart speaker to donate. Like, what do you mean? And hide his slacktivism. What is going on here? Is it because of my the whole thing? I'm gonna fix all that. I just did it because it was part of it. I gotta fix, like, my timers maybe on a lot of these Twitch bots, because they're going kind of derpy where they'll start going off and they probably need better timers. But it's like, I put it on higher. Oh, it was an ad? Oh, well, that sounds about correct considering, well. You know, I wouldn't be surprised at this point if people did ask their speakers to donate for them, but that's nothing you can do about that. Be a separate thing. Come on, thank you. So I know there are certain widgets that I can do and that, but where is it? Not stats. That's not what I'm looking for. Got scene transitions, audio mixer, rip. That's scripts. Why can't I find stuff anymore? Rip. But yeah, we're gonna be doing Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm gonna be doing the solo mode. I'm gonna probably come in, pop in, check on chat. I actually left my phone at Prophet. You're gonna probably laugh at this. I don't know if I ever mentioned, like, pretty much I'm very active in my church and that. So I go to Bible study and I help often clean up afterwards. And pretty much funny enough, I left my phone there. So if I'm a little bit slow to respond, you guys now know why. Because I have not had my phone and realized it. Like, by the time I realized it was gone, it was like I had been home for like a couple hours. And then it was like horrible, because it was like midnight. You're probably not wrong, but to make it less white, it was both a Spanish and it was Spanish and English, and I was doing English translation. You know, I forgot even why I pulled out my phone. That's more like the real question. What was I looking up? Sweet. I'm glad I can assist on imperialism. I always wanted an empire myself.
Yes, you got to.
Otherwise, how will they learn the language and the truth? That's what they told me. Especially since I'm one of them. Where is the chat window? Ew. All right. Anyway, I'm going to get into this. Let's go into our live screen. Let's go. Get my gems. I'm just waiting for. All right. So I don't think I showed. We did the dual pass. Obviously, I played a little before I did anything, but I will now show you the new dual pass since we get a chance to actually go over it in 4K. So we got mostly a bunch of SRs. We get like yeah, we get your UT coupons, but that doesn't matter. I'm honestly, if I don't complete this in 30 days like the last one, it'll be a shock. I just might have less to do. That might be the one thing stopping me. But I'll honestly say Ningard, the whole Orcrest thing is cool, but this is the only thing that makes the pass worth it. A Mokey Mokey at 100. And even then, that's a lot of work to complete a battle pass. Get into solo mode. Oh yeah, you know it. It's always time to duel. And like the thing is I've run into more Magic players lately, so right. So we completed the Lightsworns and we completed the Weather Painter Fairies. But like now we're gonna go they released the Heralds. The Heralds are weird. The Heralds are meme-y, considering they're like Simo and them recently did a history of jank just on Herald of Perfection. This deck is so jank that but it managed to win a YCS. Let's get into their storyline, cause I don't even remember a Herald storyline. But it's interesting we got one. Konami, if you hear me, give me a true Draco storyline. I want to see them go through the metaphors and everything. Even if it's based with the Draco Lords, then going up to the true kings and that, I would still love to see that whole thing play out. Just like I would love to see more stuff pop out from World Legacy. Wait, it's not even showing up on my stream from what I see. Let me fix that. I know what I did. Oh, I know what I definitely know what it is. Oh, fuck you. This hurts my soul. Well, actually, what I should do is capture specific window. That's sucker for love. I'm just capture. Go to the normal. I don't know why, but it constantly does that where it won't save whenever I'm swapping. Wait, they have a synchro event going? Ew. Wait, what's this? I don't even know what this deck is. I don't even like the look of that deck. Oh, Junks. Okay, cool. They do an update? Did I miss an update? Ooh, speed rights. I can actually use this. I just wish they would stop doing these kind of weird events in a way, because I like it, but at the same time, I'm over it. So, Prophet, what have you been up to anyway? Anyway, let's just get into solo. I'll probably do that expedition thing more or less tomorrow. Or a little bit further on in Shrem. Start reading. The Herald's Guidance. The rule of gods had ended, and human had ruled the earth for many ages. Though many gods had fled, many people continued to believe that the gods watched over the world, even as their visage changed. In the remote domain on a distant continent, gods had long been worshipped by the people living there. It was a god that spread its wings, emitted a blinding light from their entire body, the Herald. Among those living there, a few have seen or even heard the voice of the Herald. Though their depictions differ, they insisted that they seen the Herald. The atmosphere about it and its afterglow was presently that an angel they had pictured in their mind, they told. According to those who heard its voice and hadn't actually made a sound. The meaning of the words came not through their ears, but directly into their minds, they told. And when asked if they've seen or heard the Herald, their replies were eerily consistent. It was always in moments of confession that it appeared. All assert they fainted soon after, but awoke with a comforting feeling of forgiveness throughout their bodies. Some find it hard to believe these people's stories. Nonetheless, the Herald is worshipped by many people. You should play. It's good legal advice. But, like, yeah, if you're burned out, dude, don't do your thing, man. I can feel you. I was a little burnt out on Yu-Gi-Oh! And other stuff. But I really do like playing it. And I was, like, really getting burned out on Fear, like, towards the end of it. Alright, what makes Herald deck unique? There are many heralds, monsters that allow you to negate opponent's effects and sending fairies from the graveyard. Although this is very powerful, take care in using it in moderation. It can burn through your hand very quickly. It's best to use the negate effects that you focus on strategies around Herald of Ultimus and Herald of Perfection. Cards that can negate many different monster effects. Alright. Toss this up. Wow. Yay. Well, if you're planning on doing that's actually cool, because I've been playing D&D, like, lately, normally on Fridays. The past 2 weeks have been skipped out, but That's because of things happening and our DM moving. But other than that, like everything's been smooth sailing so far. Well, you have a novel in that's like D&D based. That's always interesting. You can always just put pen to paper and just start writing. That's essentially how I came out with the laundry list of lore that I have. Oh, yeah, Eva. The perfection. Okay. Okay. There you go, Eva. All right. Well, screw you. This is what I think of your negates. Take that. We don't want none of your negates here. No negates for you. Well, you ever want to share some ideas, Prophet? Let me know. I'm sorry if I'm like getting to you a little bit slow. But yeah, like I said, just write them down. They're always interesting and share with me sometime. I always like hearing when people like have like stories and that. It's always interesting. Okay, so yeah, okay. So this is just standard spiel for all this stuff. Let's get into it. Cap this off, and then we can. In the frontier, the Herald is enshrined in a temple. As for when this temple was constructed, nobody knows. It is old but well maintained, and has a sacred, solemn atmosphere about it. However, depending on who you ask, that structure may have an unusual aura about it. It appears not to have been built as a place of worship, but to contain something merely covered up as a shrine. The central part is hidden, and it is said there are gods' statues inside. And into the inner sanctum, only a few priests or deviners are allowed. The diviner of the Herald, the person who receives the oracle from the Herald, she claims that from a certain age, she began to hear the voice. And many trials and tests, a priest determined that the voice she heard belongs to the Herald. The diviner is not one who commands the people. Her role is correctly decipher the oracles for people and protect them from natural disasters. Her resolution and connection with people had helped pass along the future generations her role of diviner. And one girl will continue as the new diviner to connect people with the gods. And that, my friends, is the story of the Heralds. We got some earth orbs. Let's go. Let's go into the store. Preparation of rights. All right. Let's see what we not what we have here, because I'll probably just cap off that. Because I don't. How much time do I have left? We're at 41 minutes. I got a little bit over an hour. Oh, okay, I actually like when it's a bunch of series of short stories that string together. That's one of the reasons why I am so big into Lovecraft. Because they don't look like they're syncing together so much till like later on. But I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick. I'll BRB. Alright, bye. When does it start? Okay, the 11th. Okay. It starts tomorrow. Wait. Yeah. What monarchs is banned in this ill? I like that none of my Oh, those are gone. I can run Draco. I can't run Trickstar. But I could probably run Trickstar Wind Witches. Yeah, I can do this. This is like no big deal. Or that you use special summon in defense, but like why'd you want to do that? That's a waste of time. Like I would just the only thing I would change out of this deck is a couple things. I would add, remove this. That's unnecessary. Trickstar Fetch should be at 3. Now, well, 2 is actually fine. I would get run out one rid of a fusion. I'd get rid of a fusion. I'd also get rid of these torrential tributes. And replace it with Dark Room. I would get rid of this bouquet because it's useless. And pop in this. I'd get rid of this and put in a terraforming. I'll keep that because that'll make their I would diminish this down to 1. That's what I would do. I would get rid of, honestly, I would get rid of Regenki. I'd probably keep the honest. Yeah, I'll just do True Draco. I just edit that. That was another. It's trap. Okay. I really need two Denlongs. Interesting. Right, well, I'm not even sure what to do at the Well, that I. When do I get my next update? Yeah, well, yeah, definitely. Because if I remember correctly, Lovecraft deemed did himself as well into an intergenerational thing. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to I'll use my True Kings. I'm not trying to be serious. I'm probably gonna make some guy's life miserable though, playing these. Wow, I made someone salty. Mmm, that's some good salt, guys. We got him. I should save that. I'm going to save that. I'm going to make that a clip. May this be a lesson, everyone. Don't be salty. I didn't even destroy anything. That's terrible. I just like. I guess I'm almost close to like my. The SRs that I need. Because. Let me just quickly check what I need in the Trickstars. Swap accessories. Guess that works. Into the brains. Wait, I heard something. What went off? Oh, hey Anna, how you doing? Thanks for the 6. To Jesus, Anna, were you really bit spamming me? What did I do? Who did I murder? This is what he may feels like, I bet. When we do this, did I never set up a bit thing? That's weird. I feel like I brought great shame to my family by not setting up a bit thing. So what brings you to this lovely place, Ina? True. I can't argue. I do know how it feels now. I am. I know this will never end, and I don't know how I feel about it. Oh yeah, now I get to edit the Cyber Dragons. That's right. I'm not restricted anymore. So I can... Related. Add, plus. Sorry, I got distracted by Cyber Dragon cores. No, I don't do emergency makes sense when I put 3. Because that's my searcher. Core will help me. Tune. Cyber End Dragon. Good. Yeah. So I remember correctly, most of this stuff is cyber production plant. Rep systems in 1, 2, 3. Cyber load. Is it cyber load? Which is the next one? Is it cybernetic fusion? I do not know how to build a cyber dragon deck if anyone is watching. Alright, I know this is probably super jank, but at least it's something. I actually don't think I need... I think I only need one of these. Mega Fleet. Alright, I stopped hurting bits for a while. I think he stopped. We did it. We did it. We beat the Ina. Yeah, I know it's super jank because I've never done a Cyber Dragon thing. Thank you, Ina. I appreciate you. Thanks for all the bits. And thank you for coming by. May the Force and whatever else be with you. All right. So. Yes, I know. It is the jankiest of jank. You gotta love it. I don't know. I need to look up a Cyber Dragon build. We will just save this and return to this at some very other time. The one deck I do know how to build semi-competently is obviously Trickstar. And I will tell you this. There shouldn't be a normal Mirror Force in here. That was the first mistake. Two, there shouldn't be any Torrential Tributes. That is another issue because they can't... There's no advantage off of it. This gives me more advantage off of just because this is burn. You don't really want to play too many Trickstar Fusions just because of jank. This is the wrong hand trap because I can't pull anything. This is not set up unless they're trying to do a mirror match. All right, so. One, no one should be playing bouquet. That's just a terrible idea because it does absolutely nothing. And you should never play this stage, so you get out of here. That's too much. And you shouldn't. Destruction is good, but I don't think you need another a Regenki and a Lightning Storm. That just seems like too much. One, you either play Chain Summoning at 3 or you play it at none. Two, if you're going to play a proper burn deck, you should always play Dark Room of Nightmares at max. Dude, you're not playing Trickstar if you're not playing Droll. There should always be a Droll or Ash in here at some point. You're going to play Mirror Force in a Trickstar or Burn deck. Play Storming, so that way you return everything to the hand with Lycoris on the field. Or the Glasswind that does... When do you do something on summon? Or is normal special summon, and for like 500, you can only. Yeah. See, all this is meant to pump Wind Witches onto the field. That's useless because Trickstars don't depend on extra deck. Nor do Wind Witches. Minus. Add. Now, see. This is a one of. Yeah. See, if you're going to put Sweet Guitar in this, you should also probably put Crystal Bell. Because at least Crystal Bell can do something effectively. What else can I do with this? It's good that they have these negates here, because these work well with the Wind Witches and the Synchros and that, which are great. Because it'll help me beat over bigger things. I do think that might help. Because we got three of Ice Spell. Special summon this card from your hand when you do. Yeah, because this gets our stuff started for our Wind Witches. It's kind of like Candia. Pop brings out Lycoris, which brings out there, which also stacks on. I definitely don't think. And for Fest, you should probably be playing Fest at. Two. Wait, is this just for in their hand or graveyard. Yeah, I feel as though this can be good, but this seems very suggestive. I might pop that off in favor of... I think this might be useful, but in the same way... Wait. Did I accidentally delete two chain summonings at some point? Yeah, this definitely seems like another one of. Yeah, I'll just add the extra ash for the sake of it. Alright. Save changes for now. I might get rid of that Nightmare Unicorn. I don't see it being super feasible. Man, Yu-Gi-Oh! Got me overthinking in that. Play maybe one or two more matches, and then I'll probably call it for today. I'll be on longer playing more Yu-Gi-Oh! I'll be playing more like, you know, what we're used to. I'll play one. Yeah, I'll do one more match, then I gotta... Wait, oh wait, he's going first. Okay, cool. I already know what I can do if he, depending on what he's playing. And how bad do you want me to make your day? Why is he playing 55 cards? Who the fuck does this guy think he is? Who are you? Who sent you? Oh, you were playing ill. You disgust me. Why is it taking... That's one. Okay. Man, I smacked the living daylights out of that dude. Let's do one more, then I'm going to do my pulls for the day, then I'll get into everything else. Hopefully I'm not dealing with more Dark Magician decks. They can be annoying if they're built right. But the chances of them being built right are, like, very slim pickings. So, Bo, how are you doing today? You still around and hanging out? And he held himself up for an entire turn, man. But if you can't put anything on the field this turn, you're dead. That means nothing to me. I can just get rid of my Mariami and put something else. It's even more annoying. What? Oh, well. Man, I've not played ranks in like a forever. I hope everyone in chat is doing well. All right, so yeah, I think they're getting ready. All right. Oh, dope. That reminds me, I need to fix my bike. Wild. Man, I should do that tomorrow at some point. Yeah, it's another synchro fest. I'm not happy about it either. I didn't like the XYZ one, and I'm sure as heck no, I'm not gonna like this one. So I don't know what they're thinking. See, this is what I kind of mean. They need better rewards for one, and they need more me playing this game more than just a couple days out of the week and then just capping off the fest and all that. This is a major problem that I've been having with this lately. Let's hope and see what we get. All right. Okay. The two things that'll keep this game alive are, one, content, which I really want to be done, and two, tournaments that actually will, or things that actually will be relevant. Wait, what? Mass Beast? You can just... Ew. I don't know how to feel about that. He's a big beater, but how relevant is this? This is 8 stars. I can probably... That's a vanilla and doesn't do anything. She just literally just gave me a big stick. That's all they really did. So the problem is, if I'm playing tomorrow, and I've literally only played like 3 to 4 duels, and completed one solo mission, solo section. How much more? I'll even do one more. See if we can get a little bit up there. I'm pretty sure we can have this where this is just marked as cleared. Wow, that's even worse. This is like a worst hand you'd want to see as a 6 set, someone facing a 6 set. It's only gonna get worse. Oh, this is death. Whack. This is just stupid stuff that I do for fun. Don't be as ridiculous with me with your nonsense. Smack. All right, we're at 7. All right, time for me to call it. All right. Well, thank you everyone who rolled in and everything for the bits and all that. Welcome in, Annie. You came in time for me to raid. I still believe in you. Who else is playing Master Duel? Let me check real quick. Oh, someone has an anniversary. Let's go raid them and say hello. They're also playing Master Duel, so. All right. Raid. Me also just swap over to just catting for a bit while I fix our raid up. Right. There we go. Let's go over and say hello to Cafe Feco, I believe is how they pronounce their name. Give me one second. I will make the. All right. All right, hoot hoot. For the regular. Oh yeah, let's go say hi to them. There's your raid command.